This video is sponsored by Envato Elements. In this video, I'm going to show you how I achieved this frosted glass effect for my UI mockup, and I'm going to show you how I created this little preview to show off your app. Let's get started. Okay, so I use an iPhone, so my composition is set up with the same aspect ratio as the screen on my iPhone. If you're going to mock up an app for another OS, then you'll just want to make sure that your composition matches the aspect ratio of whatever phone that you're using. I also have this image that I downloaded from Envato Elements as a background to my app. You need a background that is not just a solid color to sell the frosted glass effect. I'll start by making my UI element using the rectangle tool up at the top. I want the corners on this UI element to be rounded, so I'll go to my shape layer in my timeline and twirl open the menus until I reach the rectangle path. And then I'll make adjustments to the rounded corners until I'm satisfied with the shape. Next, I'm going to convert my shape to a Bezier path by right-clicking on the path in my timeline and selecting Convert to Bezier Path. Now, this part is important because we are going to copy this path onto a mask on an adjustment layer. And mask paths are only able to use Bezier paths. If you want to learn more about Bezier paths and parametric paths and what the differences are, go watch my video on shape layers where I explain the difference. Next, I'm going to change the fill to a gradient fill by holding Alt and clicking on the fill at the top toolbar. Then I'll click on the rectangle without holding Alt to open up the gradient settings, and I'm going to make some minor adjustments to my gradient. First, I'm going to match the two colors. In this case, I'm going to use white on both ends of my gradient. And then on the top here, I'm going to select this little thingy at the right, which represents the opacity of the gradient, and I'm going to turn this one down to zero. I'll hit OK, and now you'll see that there's this line with two dots at the end. This line represents the path of our gradient. I'm going to position my gradient to go across my rectangle diagonally to create a sort of sheen across the glass. Because even though glass is mostly transparent, it does reflect some light, especially frosted glass. Next, I'm going to do the exact same thing with the stroke. I'm going to switch the stroke to a linear gradient and create the same gradient. The path of the stroke gradient is represented by this dotted line. I'm going to have this gradient go in the opposite direction of my fill gradient. This acts as a kind of edge sheen and just helps define the shape of our glass panel a little bit better down here in the right corner where the fill gradient falls off. We're done with the UI panel for now. Next, we need to create an effect that will blur everything behind the panel. For this, we'll use an adjustment layer. To create an adjustment layer, go up to Layer, then New, and Adjustment Layer. Adjustment layers are empty layers that you can apply effects to, and that effect will apply to any layers below it. So let's move the adjustment layer below our shape layer because we don't want it to blur our shape layer, and we want to make sure it is above the background. Let's rename our adjustment layer to Blur, and while we're at it, let's rename our shape layer so that we can stay organized. Next, right-click on your adjustment layer and go to Mask and select New Mask. This adds an empty mask to the layer. Now, remember when I had you convert the shape path to a Bezier path before? Now, we need to copy that shape path and paste it to the mask path on our adjustment layer. Select the path and hit Ctrl-C. It feels a little weird because you feel like you're not really copying anything, but you did. Just trust me on that one. Now, go to the mask path on your adjustment layer. If it's not there, then just select the adjustment layer and hit M, and that will bring up the mask path. Select the mask path and hit Ctrl V to paste the path to this mask.
Next,
parent your adjustment layer to the shape layer. That way, when you animate the shape layer's position, size, or rotation, the adjustment layer will move along with it. For those of you who may not be familiar with parenting, to parent our layers, we'll just use the pick whip here and drag it up to the layer we want it to follow. This is sort of like linking layers in Photoshop. Now, to finish off this effect, we need to apply a blur effect. I'm going to use the Fastbox Blur effect, and I'm going to apply it to my adjustment layer. I'll then crank up the blur radius to my liking, and now you can begin to see the frosted glass effect.
Now, I'm mocking up a financial app, so this little glass element I've created is going to represent a debit card or a credit card of some sort. So I'm going to add some text layers and a logo that I found on Envato Elements. I think I searched for a financial logo and just look for something that looks simple that you might find on a bank card. I'll add the name and an expiration date, and I think that looks good. I think it'll pass as some kind of credit card. Okay, next, I'll make sure that all these text layers and this logo are also parented to my main rectangle shape layer so that they'll move as I animate this layer. I'll use the rectangle shape layer to drive the animation. Okay, so I went ahead and added some animation and some extra UI elements, as well as this little navigation bar at the bottom with some icons from an icon set I downloaded from Envato Elements. And so now the next step is to place this composition into our final video. So as I mentioned in the intro, today's sponsor is Envato Elements. For this app mockup preview, I am using a template I downloaded from Envato Elements. As you can see, they have a huge selection of high quality templates just like this one to choose from. I ended up going with this one because I like this particular animation for the intro to this video. So once I've picked my template, I just hit this little download icon, create my project, and then download the asset. Back in After Effects, I'll just import the project file that I downloaded from Envato Elements into my current project. Okay, once imported, you should have a new folder that contains all the compositions for that template file. I know from previous experience with this template file, I want to use scene one. And so I will open scene one and we can preview our animation. Now, to place our composition into the phone screen, we'll go down to the composition labeled holder one. And we'll double click that to open it. We'll delete this file here, and then we will just drag our composition into the timeline. Now, obviously it's way too big because the composition settings that they're using aren't exactly the same resolution that we use, but that's okay. We can just right click on our composition in the timeline, go up to transform and fit to comp. And because we're using the same aspect ratio as the iPhone, it will perfectly fit within the composition. Now, going back to scene one, we can now see that our composition is placed within the phone and it will animate. It's that easy. They've set everything up for us. So just to preview this, obviously you can replace this opening logo with your logo, and then you can add any kind of messaging that you want to add here by changing the text. So there you have it, guys.
Hey, thanks for checking out the video. I hope it was helpful. If you felt like it was helpful, make sure you hit that like button. It really does help me in the YouTube algorithms. Also, if you want more content like this in the future, make sure you're subscribed with that bell notification turned on so that you're notified the next time I upload. Also, a huge thanks and a shout out to Envato Elements for sponsoring today's video. If you want to try out Envato Elements, make sure you use the link in the description of this video. That helps support the channel and it tells Envato Elements I sent you. We'll see you guys in the next tutorial.